Hello children, how's going? I think everything is going well with you, right? I know you are waiting for the new chapter, isn't it? What's our new chapter? Yes, it is cell clusters. What do you mean by cell clusters? You know very well about cell, right? In the first chapter, we have very well studied about cells. Now, here is our Anirudh. With the gist of our first chapter, let us listen to him.
Hi friends, myself Anirudh from 8E. In this video, I am going to discuss about the summary of the chapter, Life's Mysteries in Little Chambers. So, we studied about the microscope and its parts, uses of the parts, and we studied about how to prepare an observation material. And we studied how to prepare an activity note. And we studied discovery of cell by Robert Hooke. Cell theory. Who put forward the cell theory? What is in the cell theory? And we studied what are the cell organelles in the plant cells, like mitochondria, nucleus, and so on. We studied to compare animal cell and plant cell. And we studied what is prokaryotes, eukaryotes, and what is cytoplasm and protoplasm. And we studied about different types of microscope like electron microscope and compound microscope. And we studied what is the reason for the color change when the fruit ripen. And we studied what is the nucleus and its parts, the parts of the nucleus. Nucleus is a very important part in the cell. What are the parts in nucleus? Nucleolus, chromatin reticulum, and so on. We studied about chromoplast, leucoplast, and chloroplast. Okay, so bye. This is Anirudh signing off.
And cell is the basic structural and functional unit of an organism. And both unicellular and multicellular organisms. So in this chapter, what we are going to study about? We have already studied about cells. Then what is the cell clusters? See, this is a flower. This is a flower. Then, what is this? See, there are many flowers. And what can we call this? Yes, this is a bunch of flowers or clusters of flowers. Isn't it? So, this is a flower and this is a cluster of flowers. That is, a similar kind of flowers are there together. This is what a cell is also in our body. If this is a cell, these are a cluster of cells. So we have a term for this cluster of cells. Before going to that, let us know how these different cells are functioning in our body and what are the different kinds of cells in our body. Look at this picture. There is a boy, that is Unnikuttan, had a doubt that all organs are made up of cells. Even then, each organ is different, right? Our nose, tongue, mouth, and inside our body, heart, lungs, kidney, these are all different, looking different, isn't it? And its functions also different. How is it possible? Yes, There will be something different kinds of cells will be there, isn't it? Do you think? What's your opinion? Are they made up of same kind of cells? Never. If it is made up of same kind of cells, then how it come different? It may be same. Our body will be looking everywhere same. There is no chance for a differentiation. Isn't it? Are you clear? Yes. So we have different types of cells, that is different kinds of cells, and which are millions of numbers in our body, that is nerve cells, muscle cells, bone cells, and blood cells, and skin cells, and many different kinds of cells are there in our body, in which all the organs and organ systems are made up of. So look at this picture again. In this human body, it is made up of many these kind of different kinds of cells, which are of 200 kinds of cells are there in our body, and millions of these different kinds of cells are there in our body. Now read this description.
Each part of the human body is made up of millions of different kinds of cells. There are about 20 different kinds of cells, like nerve cells, muscular cells, blood cells, bone cells, etc. in the human body.
Now you have understood there are different kinds of cells in our body. You might have studied this same in your 6th standard, isn't it? This 6th standard first chapter, it is also about cells. And you have studied the names, at least the names you might have studied, that is nerve cell, muscle cell, bone cell, blood cells. Do you remember that, the diagrams and all? Yes, the same we are going to study deeply in this chapter. Now you look at this boy's doubt. What a wonder our body is. Like, how do millions of such cells function effectively without getting messed up? So this boy is thinking that there are millions of cells in our body, isn't it? So how these millions of cells function effectively to carry on our physiological activities? Do you know what are our physiological activities taking place inside our body? Yes, that is digestion, respiration, excretion, blood circulation. These many things are happening every time in our body, and it is going effectively also. So this is possible only if the cells are functioning effectively. So we have come across with the different kinds of cells in our body, and it is functioning effectively in each organ. Each organ is functioning, each organ system is functioning. Isn't it? Our digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system. These are all made up of different organs, combination of organs. And these organs are made up of different kinds of cells. Isn't it? Is that clear? So, our body is indeed a wonder. Now you may be thinking, how is it possible? Yes, it is possible with a cluster of cells. That is, I have said earlier, we have cluster of cells in our body that we can call it as tissues. So tissues are a group of similar cells that have a common origin and also have a common function. So same kind of cells group together to perform a function. So each tissue have its own function, and it is made up of similar kind of cells. So the well-being of our human body depends on a systematic and regulated action of these cells which will form clusters in our body, that is tissues. So we have many tissues in our body in which our organs are made up of, and in turn the organs combine together to form an organ system which helps in our physiological activities. Now it is very important to know the definition of tissues, then only you can continue the next studies. Okay, tissues are group of similar cells that have a common origin and perform specific functions. So each tissue has a common origin, that is, you know, we have cell, each cell divides also, and that's why group of cells are formed. So one cell divides into many cells. So each tissue has a common origin, that is, a common one cell will be there in which our every part is made up of. Ella part indeyum tissue na oru common origin undavum, that is a cell. Common origin means a one cell will be there. This one cell divides and divides and divides to form millions of cells, and it combine together to perform a specific function, that is, tissue performs specific functions. I hope you are clear about it. There are different kinds of tissues both in plants and animals, that is, multicellular organisms. You know, this tissue is possible in only in multicellular organism, because in unicellular organism there is only one cell which performs all the functions in it. So it is not possible for an unicellular organism to have a tissue, isn't it? So the multicellular organisms is another level, that is, they are made up of tissues and they are made up of organs, organ system, etc. So the coordinated action of these tissues, illa tissue ni coordinated actions, helps to perform specific functions in our body, that is, all the physiological functions are carried out with the help of the coordinated action of these tissues. Have you observed the muscle cell and nerve cell in the illustration 2.1? They all are cells, isn't it? In this human body there are many cells shown here, that is, nerve cell, muscle cell, bone cell, blood cell. They all are cells. Even then they look different according to the different organs, and its functions also different. But how is it possible? Because all these cells have originated from a single cell. We all the human beings, all the animals, all plants and every creature have originated from a single cell. So in this, from this single cell, how is it possible to differentiate into different kinds of cells which looks different and performs different functions? This doubt will be cleared by our Maya teacher, and she will be continued with next two topics, very important topics. So listen carefully, enjoy.
So dear children, Amala teacher told you that the tissues in all living beings have a common origin, isn't it? As you all know that tissues are groups of cells. So from this we can infer that all living beings, including human beings, are developed from a common origin, that is, a common cell known as zygote. So what is zygote? Zygote is a single eukaryotic cell which is formed by the union of a female gamete and a male gamete. So a zygote is formed through sexual reproduction. So zygote is the earliest fundamental stage of a multicellular organism, and later on the zygote undergoes divisions and form fetus, and the fetus consists of cells of different size, shape and content, and each fetal cell later on changes into more specialized type of cells with the specific structure and function through a process known as cell differentiation. So cell differentiation is a process in which a cell changes into another type of cell. Usually one cell changes into more specialized type of cells. Differentiation occurs numerous times during the development of a multicellular organism as it changes from a simple zygote to a complex system of tissues and cell types. So, as a result of cellular differentiation, from the fetal cells, more specialized cells are developed. And which are these specialized cells by which our body is made up of? They are nerve cells, then blood cells, bone cells, and muscular cells or muscle cells. So these are the important cells by which our body or all living beings, animals' body is made up of. There are 200 different types of cells are there in a living being's body. Of these are the important cells. Is that clear? Now, you have a doubt, isn't it? What may be the reason behind the different types of tissues are seen in a living being's body? The reason is, you know that in a office or in a factory, different types of people are working, isn't it? And these people are specialized in their own jobs, isn't it? So for performing a particular function in a factory or a office, different people who are specialized in a particular job are utilized, isn't it? In the same manner, in our body also, or in animal's body also, the jobs are biologically different, or biologically different jobs are taking place in an animal's body. And for performing these jobs, organs and organ systems are there in our body. So to perform their functions, they have to be made up of different types of tissues which are good in their own job. For example, stomach, you know, in the stomach, digestion is taking place, isn't it? So the stomach is made up of these different types of cells. So in order to sense the appetite, nerve cell is there. In order to grind, the different types of muscle cells are there. So that is why each and every organ in our body is made up of different types of tissues. Hope it is clear. Now I will explain the illustration 2.2 given in the textbook. So in this illustration, you can see the zygote, the fetal cells, and the specialized cells formed from the fetal cells. So there you can see the zygote is undifferentiated cell, which means it is not differentiated, that is its structure and the function is not determined. And when we come to the fetal cells, they are developed from the zygote. When the zygote undergoes continuous division, fetal cells are formed, and the fetal cells are partially differentiated. That means they are not specialized cells, but they have a shape, size and content, but their structure and functions are not fully determined or not fully differentiated. And when the specialized cells like nerve cells, bone cells, etc. are formed from these fetal cells, they are fully differentiated. That means they have their own specific structure and function. So, hope now you have understood what is cell differentiation and how do different types of cells are formed from zygote. Now we will move on to the next topic. So the next topic begins with a newspaper report. A giant leap in stem cell research. Science has succeeded in artificially developing tissues from stem cells. A lot of research has gone into this achievement, which would become a milestone in the field of medicine. So this is the newspaper report. By reading this, Sneha, a girl, she has a doubt. What is her doubt? What are these stem cells? Whether these stem cells are originated from seeds? So children, what do you think about it? Have you heard about stem cells? No. So stem cells are a special kind of cells which can develop into any kind of cells. That means a stem cell can undergo cell differentiation and can change into any type of cell. So when the cells in a tissue are destroyed, a stem cell can undergo cell differentiation and change into that particular cell. So the thing is, either it can change into another type of cell or it will exist as such in our body. And the stem cells are found in our body, in the body parts like bone marrow, then digestive tract and skin. And there are two types of stem cells, embryonic stem cells and adult stem cells or somatic stem cells. So here we are discussing about what is the importance of stem cells in the medical field, especially in the field of medicine, isn't it? So the embryonic cells are utilized in research and adult cells or somatic cells, they have the ability to change into any desired type of cell. Is that clear? So it is expected that the researches in stem cell will bring miraculous changes in the medical field, such as for finding out medicine for cancer, then Parkinson's disease and diabetes. And at the same time, stem cells are also used for developing artificial organs. And we can develop, or science can develop cells, artificial cells from stem cells in the research centers under specific laboratory conditions also. So that is why it has been said that a giant leap in the stem cell research. Because if it is possible for making new cells or desired type of cells from a stem cell, it is really very helpful for many people, those who are suffering from various kinds of diseases. So that's all about stem cell, and we can say that The zygote is also a kind of stem cell, or the fetal cells are also a type of stem cells which can develop into any type of cells. So hope you all have understood about the cell differentiation as well as stem cells. So find out the answers for the indicators given in both the concepts. Try to find out the answers, and if you have any doubt, you can contact me or Amala teacher. No problem in that. So hope you have understood the concepts we have discussed in this class. So study well, because all these are new for you. All these concepts are new for you. So thorough reading is required here. So we will meet in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.